A very good morning to students. Welcome to our maths class. We'll be starting the revision from 1st to 17th July. We'll be doing the revision. After revision, you'll be getting the timetable of your exam. You'll be having your exam from 20th July. So let us start our revision. Now it's time to study, to work harder. So whatever we are giving in the revision worksheet, you have to do it in your classwork copy. You have to practice it, and if you are having any doubts, any queries, you are free to ask. So let us start the revision. Today we'll be doing the revision of chapter second. We'll be doing the revision of chapter second. I'll be taking the questions from the exercise 2A, 2B and 2C. This exercise we have done, so we'll be revising this. I'll be taking the questions from 2A, 2B and 2C. And similar question I have given you in the worksheet. What you have to do? You have to do that questions by your own. So let us start. You have to write the number in words which is shown in this abacus. I am drawing an abacus. This I am writing ones, tens, hundred and thousand. I am drawing an abacus. What is this? I am drawing abacus. So you have to write the number in words what is shown in this abacus. Now I will be drawing the rings. In this I am drawing 1, 2, 3 rings, 2 rings. In this no ring I am drawing, in this only 1 ring. Now you have to write what is there in this abacus. You have to write the number in words. So we will be starting from the ones. In ones place 3 rings are there, so I have written 3. In tens place 2 rings, so I have written 2. Hundreds place no ring is there, so 0. And in thousand place 1 ring is there. So the number is 1023. Now what is the smallest, if I say you, what is the smallest 4 digit number? What is the smallest 4 digit number? 1, and you will be putting 30. It is the smallest 4 digit number. What about the largest 5 digit number? For largest I'll be writing 9 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So in this way you write the smallest 4 digit number and the largest 5 digit number. For the smallest you have to write 0 and for the largest you have to write 9. The next if I write any number, like if I write 12,018, you have to write this in numeral. How you will be writing? What is written here? 12. So I will be writing 12,018. So I will be writing like this. It is 12,018. Let us take a greater number. 59,68,003. You have to write this number in numeral. So you have to 59. You have to start reading from here. 59. So I am writing 59. Lakh 68,000 and 3. So I will be writing this number like this. 59,68,003. So you have understood how to write the given number in numeral. The next I'll be telling you how to put the commas. If I write a given number and if I tell you to put the comma at the right place, if I write any number and you have to put the commas. If I ask you to put the commas in the given number, I have written here the number. If I tell you to put the comma, here no comma are there, you have to put the comma at the right place. So how you will be putting the comma? You will be counting from here, from the right hand side. 1, 2, 3, after every 3 digit you will be putting one comma. Then after every 2 digit you will be putting the comma. So we put the comma in this way. You have to start from here. Initially after every 3 digit, then after every 2 digit you have to put the comma. Now if I ask you which number is formed if 5 is replaced by 0 in this given number. I have written here a number. So in the question, what is asked? What number is formed if I replace 5 with a 0 in the given number? Look at this number. In this number 5, how many times 5 it comes? 2 times. 1, 5 is here, another is here. What you have to do simply, instead of this 5, you have to write 0 because you have to replace 5 with a 0. So what will be your answer? 1, instead of 5, I will be writing 0. Then 6. 8, again 5 comes, so instead of 5 I will be writing here the 0. The next it come about the place value. You have to tell the place value of this given number. You have to tell the place value of the underlined number. Which number is underlined? 6. So what is the place value of 6? You will be counting from here, 1s, 10s, 100. So the place value of 6 is 100 because it is coming at the 100s place. So what we have discussed till now, we have discussed the place value also. But if I write any number, I am putting the commas. If I ask you which digit is there at the last place, you have to tell me the digit which is there at the last place. Okay. Which digit is there at the last place? That you have to tell me. At the last place, which digit is there in this given number? So you will be counting from here, 1s, 10s, 100. 1000, 10,000, lakh. So your answer will be 4. So that's all for today's class. What we have done today, students? I have told you about the abacus. I have drawn the diagram of the abacus, how to write the given number in the abacus. This diagram, you remember, I drawed initially. After the abacus, I have told you about the smallest and largest number, how to write the smallest and the largest number. I have told you how to put the commas at the right place. And we have discussed about the place value. After the place value, we have also done how to write the given number in the numeral form. So we have done the questions related to this topic. So what you have to do, I'll be giving you the revision worksheet based on this topic only. So you'll be doing it by your own, and if you are having any doubts, any queries, you can ask. That's all for today's class. Have a nice day. Take care and study regularly. Thank you, students.